In today's video, I'm sharing the 10 things I no longer buy. There are a lot of things that I used to buy that I don't now because I'm more intentional with what I'm spending my money on. As I've grown a little bit older, my priorities and my spending habits have changed. So let's talk about what I no longer buy and why I don't buy those things. As I go throughout this list, I want you to think of items that you no longer buy and then share them in the comments. All right, the first thing that I no longer buy is fast fashion, or just things that are on sale. I used to get email newsletters from different stores that I really liked shopping at, and if something was on sale, then I would go buy that item, but I didn't necessarily need that item. And I know there are a lot of trendy clothes out there, and that fashion changes constantly because they do want you buying a lot of different clothes, a lot of new clothes. I know that skinny jeans have come in and apparently they've gone out and we're going back to wide leg jeans or even bell bottoms, but you know what? I'm sticking with my skinny jeans. I like them and I'm going to continue to wear them. I think I look good in them. And plus, I have accumulated enough clothing over the years that I don't need to be constantly buying more clothing. Honestly, I have a coat that I've probably had at least 15 years, I want to say. It is a great winter coat. And I have just kept that coat in good condition and I continue to wear it. Just a few ways that I have stopped buying so much on clothes is, I already mentioned this, but unsubscribing from newsletters from my favorite clothing stores. If I'm not seeing what's on sale, I'm not tempted to buy it. And even just going to the mall less often or hardly at all. I used to go to the mall on my lunch break when I had my 9-to-5 job because I would just bring my food with me. I would eat lunch either in the car or in the lunchroom and then I would have extra time. So I would just walk around the mall. And when I did that, I would find something I wanted to buy and then I would spend money. So I no longer go to the mall on my lunch breaks. And also I used to get together with my girlfriends and we would plan a trip to Ross and we would all buy a cute outfit. And now we can do something else. Or if I do go with them, then I don't bring my credit card into Ross. And one of my friends mentioned that she watches videos about landfills. There are tons of clothing items in our landfills. Because of this fast fashion, people are just purchasing so many clothes and then discarding it. They may donate it, but a lot is ending up in our landfills. That's just an extra thing to consider when you are tempted to buy another outfit. And then item number two is impulsive purchases. Like I mentioned, I would buy a shirt or a pair of pants or a dress whenever I wanted to, and I didn't really plan out that I needed a new dress. But this also goes for other things, maybe decorations in my home or just different little gadgets or even buying gifts for other people. I'm just more conscious about what I'm spending my money on. And not that I'm not buying gifts for anyone, I'm just more conscious about how much I'm spending on the gift and what the gift is. By being more conscious, I end up just spending less money. I can plan ahead for my purchases, and I really know what I want to be purchasing. To give you a specific example, this happened recently. I am looking at extending out my patio in my backyard. So I'm going to have a lot more space out there and I want to get some patio chairs. And I thought about getting a couple of those lounger patio chairs, but I wasn't really sure about it. And so I didn't make the purchase, but it was still on my mind. And I think I've shared this in other videos, but I was kind of using that one more day strategy, thinking, well, could I wait one more day to buy these patio chairs? And can I wait one more day after that and one more day? And anyway, it turns out that the patio chairs I was thinking about, they went on sale and I decided, you know what? Yes, I do want these patio chairs. I thought about it enough. They are still on my mind. It is something that I still want. And so I ended up purchasing them, but it wasn't an impulse purchase. I made a conscious decision to spend my money on those items, on those patio chairs. So it's not that I'm not spending money at all. I'm just being more conscious about what I'm spending my money on. And then item number three that I've stopped spending my money on is expensive activities, unless it is something that I really want to spend my money on. It goes back to the other one of being a more conscious spender. I no longer just go to the movies or do other paid activities unless it is something I really want to spend my money on. I actually have my friends over for dinner at my place quite a bit, or we'll even rotate homes and go to someone else's house for dinner. That way we're not spending money on going out to eat. That's not really a priority for me to be spending my money on. And plus, it's nicer when you're in someone's home. You don't feel rushed like you do at the restaurant. If you can tell that the server wants your table and he wants you to leave, you just have a more comfortable atmosphere when you're at someone's house. You can just eat and chat and take your time and feel more relaxed. And to give another example, some of my friends are going to a chocolate dipping night, and I don't really love chocolate, so while the activity might sound fun, it's not something I want to spend my money on, so I declined that invitation. I used to think that I just need to be social and go to all of the activities. There are actually a lot of free things I would rather do. To give you another example, I love going for walks outside. I love just walking around the park, different trails. And that is a completely free activity. I can do that alone, or I can invite other people to come with me. And if we are just walking, that is something very simple. It's not an intense activity that we're doing, or we're not watching a movie, so we can't really chat. By going walking, we can easily chat with one another and build a deeper relationship. And then item number 4 that I've stopped spending money on is cleaning supplies. There are a number of cleaning supplies out there, and there are just so many different brands and products to clean different things. And I have a lot of cleaning supplies, and I do not need to be spending money on cleaning supplies anymore. And honestly, just having vinegar and Dawn dish soap, those can take care of a lot of your cleaning needs. So I feel like I really don't need hardly any cleaning supplies. I remember a few years ago, okay, it was more than a few, it was probably 12 or 15 years ago, there was someone that knocked on my door and she was selling a cleaning item and she showed me how well it worked and I was really impressed and so I bought the cleaning item. And I no longer do that. I keep my cleaning supplies very simple and I don't need any expensive cleaning supplies. Vinegar and Dawn dish soap and water do a great job. And then item number 5 that I no longer spend money on is excessive home decor. There are nice things that I like to have in my home, but I do not like a lot of knickknacks or a lot of things on my shelves. I like to keep it pretty clean. So I'm not spending a lot of money on decorating my home. I'm more intentional on what items I want in my home. Because honestly, I do not want to get a storage shed or just have a bunch of stuff that I have to keep organized. And there are things that I do buy. I did buy couches last year, and I was really intentional with that purchase. I knew that I was looking for a larger couch so I could fit a lot of people on it, and I wanted it to be soft and super comfortable and like the look of it. So I went to a lot of different stores looking for the perfect couch, and I ended up finding one that I really loved. So of course I spent the money on that. And to give one more example, I have this mirror. It is a huge mirror that my parents had given me. It was in their bathroom before they remodeled. And I had it with me at my old place and my other old place, and I brought it to this place. And I had a friend help me build a frame around it. So I think it looks awesome right now. And it just was the cost of the wood because I already had the mirror. So if you are looking for different ways to decorate your home, you can find at least discounted things. But again, I'm not into just filling up my home just to have stuff. And then item number 6 that I no longer spend money on is trendy beauty products or even just beauty enhancing things. I keep my makeup very simple and I don't know, maybe some people don't like it, but I'm okay with it. I don't use the bright colored shades. I've used a couple of those in the past, but I'm just more neutral now and I like that. And I've actually never spent money on a manicure. I have gotten maybe 3 pedicures, but I like painting my toenails myself. I feel like I do a pretty good job with that. And honestly, even with getting my hair cut, I used to go to a nice hairstylist, and I felt like she was pretty affordable. I felt like she was even less than what a lot of my friends were paying, and she did a good job. But then I discovered the beauty school, and now I can get my hair cut for $7 plus a tip. And if you're worried about going to a beauty school, I get that, especially if you have short hair and you're very particular about how your hairstyle should be. But with longer hair, if I just need a trim, that's something that anyone can do, and they have their teachers come over and make sure that everything looks good. So I'm not really afraid to go to the beauty school, especially if I can get a $7 haircut. And I also used to get my eyebrows done. I no longer spend money on that either, and I don't know, maybe I should, but I just couldn't justify the expense anymore. I would so much rather be spending my money on other things. And then item number 7 is souvenirs. When I was younger and I was traveling, I used to collect keychains. I had a whole whole number of keychains from all the different places that I went. And then I switched over to collecting decks of cards. I like playing card games. And then I switched over to earrings. And honestly, I don't think I need any more earrings. So I'm just letting go of spending money on souvenirs. Unless it is something really specific that I want. For example, when I went to Israel, I really wanted to get one of their olive wood nativities. So I spent money on that and I am so glad I did. I put that out every Christmas and I love that souvenir. So again, it's not just not spending your money, it's about spending on what is really important to you. And then item number 8, I have really cut back on sugary foods. I look at the labels before I buy an item and see if there is any added sugars in that item, and then I decide not to purchase it. I really want to be taking care of my health. I know that my years are numbered, and the healthier that I am, then the longer I'm going to be able to live, unless some accident happens. But of course, we can't live our lives in fear, so I'm just going to live as healthy as possible. And that doesn't mean that I've cut out sugar completely. I do love sugar cookies. So if someone's going to buy me a sugar cookie, I'm not going to say no. But since I'm really conscious about the foods that I'm eating most of the time, which do not have added sugars, I feel fine about eating a sugar cookie now and again or having some treat. Tell me in the comments, because I feel like this is kind of a trend. Have you been more conscious about what you are eating? And then item number 9 that I no longer spend money on is excessive subscriptions. I do have a few of my favorite subscriptions that I actually do use, and I don't feel like I've been out of control with this, but there have been a few things I've gotten rid of. For example, I used to have a gym membership and I've gotten rid of that because I found a free Zumba class that I can go to. I also got certified to teach Zumba, so I teach Zumba every Saturday. But there are so many ways to get free exercise, I really didn't feel the need to keep my gym membership. I've even gotten rid of my Audible subscription, and I get a lot of books from the library. You can use their app and listen to books that way that are completely free. Comment below and tell me if there is a subscription that you are going to get rid of. And then item number 10, and this one is a little surprising to myself, actually. I've cut back on my travel expenses quite a bit. I do still travel a little, but I just feel like it is a lot less. I feel like my priorities have changed. I've traveled to a lot of different places and I do love traveling, but I just have different priorities right now. I've spent money on business items, and I'm also going to be spending money on redoing my entire backyard so I can travel to my nice backyard instead of somewhere exotic. And it will be a lot less expensive in the long run. Yes, it's going to be expensive to redo my backyard right now, but that's something that I am prioritizing. I like being outside and being able to go into my backyard and have a hammock or a lounge chair and having a fire pit and a grill out there. It just sounds so fun to me. I can invite people over and they don't have to buy a plane ticket to come to my backyard. They can just come on over and we can hang out and chill and build relationships. Comment below and tell me what you've stopped spending money on. I am curious to know. And if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button and share it with someone else who would like to hear this information, and hit the subscribe button to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the little bell to get notified on when I post new videos. And if you want to see even more awesome content from me, make sure and check out the videos on the side of the screen. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.